Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode. Today we'll be going for about 15 minutes, but the extra time is definitely worth it. As always, there's no BS, just AE. In this tutorial, we're going to create some infinite loop animations using a variety of shapes. I'll show you how to easily change the look of these infinite loops using some very useful tricks, which can be applied in a number of other different kinds of animations. By the end of this tutorial, you'll be creating infinite loop animations with ease, and hopefully you'll pick up on some techniques that can be applied in your everyday motion graphic projects. Please like this video so I can make that YouTube algorithm happy. Share this tutorial and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And remember to click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. And please, tell me what you learned from this episode in the comments below. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, the project file for this episode, the notes for how to create infinite loop animations, and the presets we'll be creating in this episode are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Just right-click in this area that's next to the timeline and choose New Shape Layer. Rename this Pentagon. Open this up, and let's go to our Add button here. Add in a polystar, and then we want to add in a stroke. Okay, so let's open up our polystar path. Change our type from star to polygon. This outer radius is the same thing as the size setting for a rectangle or ellipse. So this outer radius right here is going to act as our size setting. So just increase this up, and then we can close that up. Let's go down to our stroke. Make our stroke width 15. Change my color here from white to something like a blue. Go back up to our Add button here. I'm going to add in a repeater. And repeaters always come in with default settings. It defaults to a setting of 3 copies. And we open up our transform properties. The X value is always set to 100 and 0 on the Y value. So for all of these tunnels, we want to make sure that our position is always 0, 0. So that way we can't see any of the copies. The way we make our tunnel is going to be dictated by the scale setting. And make sure you're on the scale setting under the transform repeater settings. Your layer also has transform settings. Open this up. Anchor point position, scale, rotation, opacity. This is for the layer itself. So you make sure you're in the transform repeater settings. Change this scale to 50. Now we can see our other copies here. Click on copies and just add in 150 copies. These settings affect the copies that are being made. For example, when we changed our scale down to 50%, the scale of our copies was reduced by 50% exponentially instead of uniformly. So we can change this rotation value here to 45, and you can see another example of this. Instead of rotating the entire layer, it's rotating each copy 45 degrees as they're offset from one another. So the main thing to take away from that is that the transform properties of the repeater are going to interact with your shape in a much different way than the transform properties of your layer. I'm going to change my end opacity to 0. It's going to make the copies in the back fade. And the way this is going to be animated is using this offset value. You never want to go above 0. So the highest value you use needs to be 0. Put a keyframe at the beginning of our animation for 0. Go forward 5 seconds. I'm just going to hit N to loop this. Then let's make this value negative 10. If we watch it play back, we can see how this is going to kind of work. And what I meant by you can't go above 0, if we make this value here instead of negative 10, so we make it 10. Well, now it goes in the opposite direction, but then it fades off. The lower the number, the slower it's going to go. So say negative 5, watch it play back, see how it moves a lot slower. Now, if you want to go in the opposite direction, just click on offset, and that will highlight both of your keyframes here. Right click on either one of them, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframe. So now our first keyframe is negative 5, and our last one is 0, and it goes in the opposite direction. So that's the basic idea for this tunnel. Let's click on our shape layer here, go to layer, layer styles, and then we want to add in a gradient overlay. Let's close all of this up so that way we can focus just on our gradient overlay. And then for the blend mode, it defaults to normal. So let's change that to overlay. And then we want to change our style from linear to reflected. So you have all these options, choose reflected. I also want to add a glow onto this. So let's go up to effect, stylize, and let's add in a glow. Okay, so first we want to make our threshold 0, make our glow radius 150, change the composite original from behind to on top. Whatever color I choose for my stroke, I want my glow colors to be the same. So let's change this glow colors from original to A and B, open up our contents, and open up our stroke and see our color is blue here. Now let's open up our effects at this level down here by our timeline, open up glow, and now we have this color A and color B. Parent this color A to a color of our stroke and see it changes it to blue. Same thing for color B. Now our glow matches our stroke. So if I change this to orange, Well, now our colors for our glow also change. So by parenting your color A and color B from your glow to your shape layer stroke, whatever color you change your stroke to, that glow will follow. So now let's close that up and then hit U on our keyboard to bring up our keyframes. Let's click on offset, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse. That way our tonal comes towards us. And I'm just going to set our resolution down to quarter because this is going to get a little heavy with this many copies. So that's our basic tunnel there, but we can do some really cool things with this. So let's open up our Pentagon, go to contents. We can add in a trim paths. Open up that trim paths, go to beginning of the animation, set a keyframe for end at 0%, go forward maybe a second and increase that to 100%. And then if we watch this playback, we can see how this is going to open up like that. Something else we can do is if you open up your transform repeater settings, you can change the rotation. As we change this, this is going to give you a bunch of different looks. So whatever value you change this to, it's going to affect the way that your animation is going to look and how it's going to come in. The offset value is 0 to negative 5. If you want this to go faster, make that a higher value. So 0 to negative 10. I'm just going to change this back to 45. If you want to go slower, you go in the opposite direction. So maybe 0 to negative 3, and it'll be even slower. And also note, our scale is set to 50. If you increase this, it'll make the copies closer together. So see, this is 80%. And so you can get some really cool looks with this. If you want them to be further apart, make it smaller. So we were at 50, so maybe say 35. So now they're further apart. I think 50 is a good place to go. And I think speed of negative 5 seems to work pretty well. Okay, so let's create another one real quick. We'll start over. So right click, new shape layer. And we want to add in an ellipse this time. And then we want to add in a stroke. So open up these ellipse path settings. Then let's just increase this size up to say 1500. Let's increase our stroke up to 10. Choose something like a purple. Add in a repeater. Repeater settings always default to 3 copies. Our position is always 100 and 0. So make sure both these values are 0, 0. And we want to increase the number of copies we have again to 150. And then let's change our scale setting on our transform repeater down to 85. Come down here to end opacity, make this 0%. You can add an effect. So let's go up to effect, blur and sharpen, camera lens blur. Our blur map, you want to change this to the layer that you're on. So this is going to be our shape layer 1. And actually, let's go ahead and change the name of this to circle. And as you can see, it updates right here. And then we just want to increase the blur focal distance from 0. Let's maybe make that 200. And now we can see how it really starts to blur back there. So this is another option you can do to kind of get that depth of field. Use this camera lens blur effect. Okay, so let's go back to our animation. To animate this, remember we have to use the offset value. So put a keyframe at the beginning. We'll go forward 5 seconds in to loop that. And then let's make this negative 10. Make sure you stay in the negative. I'm going to change this back to quarter quality. And we watch it play back and we get something that looks kind of like that. Let me make this even a little bit quicker. So we'll say negative 15. Okay, and then let's change it back to full quality real quick. And then highlight our circle layer. So to layer styles, we're going to go to gradient overlay. And let's open up our gradient overlay settings. And again, we want to change our blend mode to overlay. And we want to change our style to reflected. And maybe we want to even make this stroke like a darker purple. So that way this gradient kind of pops better. And then I want to add that glow that we had in before. So effect, stylize, glow. We want to change our threshold to 0, our radius to 150, our composite original to on top, our glow colors to A and B. And then we're going to parent the colors from our stroke, which is this purple. So open up our effects down here, glow, and then just take this color A, parent it to our color of our stroke, and also color B. So that way our glow settings are going to match our stroke color. I just want to show you some cool things that you can do in addition to just kind of having this tunnel kind of come towards you. You can actually keyframe your repeater transform properties and see how our circle doesn't quite fill up everything. If you open up the ellipse path, just increase this a little bit until it does. Now under repeater, transform repeater, let's move our position. We'll say negative 40. So that way it goes off to the left and maybe like negative 25. So that way it's up there. So there are some adjustments you can make to get a different look for your tunnels. Put a keyframe for the position of our transform repeater. Go forward 2.5 seconds right in the midpoint and we'll change negative 40 to 40. So that way it goes to the positive side. And at 5 seconds, we'll just copy this first keyframe and paste it. Click on position. So that way we highlight all of our keyframes. Right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. So now we get this look where our tunnel is kind of moving and it will repeat this over and over again. Option click on this position keyframe and just type loop out, open and close parentheses. Let's take that keyframe off. We can option click on offset and type time times, and remember it has to be a negative, so negative 2. So now with no keyframes on your offset, this will animate and it will go indefinitely. If you want your tunnel to go in the opposite direction, you can play with the math of this. So say right now it's coming towards us. Let's say if I want to go in the opposite direction, change this to time minus 10. So it's going to be coming closer to us. But now we need to multiply that times a positive value. So time minus 10 times 2. And now we'll see it goes in the opposite direction. Just keep in mind the number of copies you have and the value of your offset. So if you run out of copies, you can just adjust the math of this expression to get the look that you're going for. Okay, and let's just do one more example of this. We're going to close this up, right click, new shape layer. We're going to call this square. We want to add in a rectangle and we want to add in a stroke. Open up our rectangle settings and let's change this to say 1500. Open our stroke settings and let's make this stroke width, we'll say 50. And I'm just going to kind of make this smaller so we can see what we're doing. And let's go back in and add in a repeater. And again, we see these default settings, 3 copies, and it goes off to the right because of this position here on 100. See, the higher the value, the further to the right, and then a negative value pushes the copies off to the left. So we're going to make that 0, 0, and then we're going to change our scale, which is going to give us that depth to 80. And then again, let's increase our number of copies to 150. And now we can increase our rectangle path to 1900. So that way it's already past us. So in our stroke settings, change the color, like a darker orange, and close that up. Layer styles. And again, we're going to add in that gradient overlay. And let's close these up so we can focus on our gradient overlay. We're going to change our blend mode from normal to overlay and our style from linear to reflected. We also want to add in a stylize glow. 0 for a threshold, 150 for radius, change behind to on top, change glow colors from original to A and B, and then let's open up our stroke settings and our glow settings, and we want to parent our color A up to our color, and our color B also up to our color. So see, this glow intensity is a little bit much. If you change this to maybe like 0.5, that way it won't be quite as intense, or maybe 0.7, and I'm going to just kind of change the color of this orange to get something a little bit better. Okay, and then I want to also go back into effect, blur and sharpen. We're going to add in that camera lens blur. And remember the blur map, you have to change that. So the layer is going to be square. And then change the blur focal distance up to 200. Then I'm also going to go into my repeater on a rectangle repeater. And I'm going to change my end opacity down to 0. So that way it does fade off as we get further in the distance. And we want to animate again our offset. So put a keyframe at the beginning, go forward 5 seconds, hit N to loop that, change that to negative 10, and watch that play back, and we see that we get something that looks kind of like that. Make sure you're under your transform properties for your repeater. If you change your rotation, say maybe make this 5, 15, you can really kind of play with this and get some really interesting, cool looks. So your rotation of your repeater is going to have a much different effect on your overall look than your rotation of your layer. With the rotation, whenever you're using a rectangle, once you get to 90 degrees, it's as if there's no effect on it whatsoever, just because of the math. But this really doesn't require much of an adjustment. As you can see, even changing it, say 5 degrees, gives it a much different look. Anything that has a stopwatch can be keyframed. So say if you put rotation at the beginning at 0, go forward, and then you change this up to 5, you can see the effect that it could have. Over time, you can animate all of these properties. You can adjust your transform repeater position. So it kind of goes off to the right like that. And then I'm going to take off these keyframes for offset. I'm going to use the expression that we talked about earlier. So option click on offset, and I'm just going to do time times negative 3. So we have it coming towards us. Change our scale from 80, maybe down to like 75. It's a little bit more distance in between these. You can adjust your stroke width. So maybe make this 30 for our scale. Maybe I want to make this 90 and then move my position over a little bit less. Just tweaking these settings very slightly is going to give you a lot of different kinds of looks. If you want to create a preset, you can bring it back in with the click of a button. So I'm going to do this with our circle shape layer, but you can do this with any one of these shape layer animations. Open up our circle and let's just close up all of these sections here. So that way we have our outermost sections showing. Click on contents, hold down shift, and then click layer styles. That way you're grabbing everything within this layer. So we'll be making a preset that's based on the contents of our shape layer, as well as the effects, which is the glow and the camera lens blur, the transform properties, and our layer styles. So let's go up here to animation, save animation preset, and make sure you're in documents, Adobe, the version you're using. I'm using 2020, user presets, and I'm going to go up here to 7-minute AE. That's where I save a lot of my presets for my tutorials, and I'm just going to call this infinite loop circle. Click save. Let's just hide all of that. If we go over here to our effects and presets panel, we can open up animation presets, user presets, 7 minute AE, and then here's our infinite loop circle. All you have to do is just double click on this. You don't have to add it to anything. You don't have to have a shape layer in there. So make sure you're at the beginning of your layer, and then let's just double click this and hit U to bring up our keyframes. And as you can see, we have our effects over here. Let's open up this layer. We also have our layer styles. So now I have this animation preset that I can bring in with just a click of a button. Just double click on the preset itself and it brings the entire animation in for you. Okay, one of the things you may want to do also is enable your motion blur. Just kind of gives you a better look. I'm always a fan of adding in motion blur whenever I'm animating a shape layer, but that's something that's completely up to you. And that is how you make an infinite loop animation using shape layers and how you can save it as a preset and bring it back in with just a click of a button. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Please share this tutorial and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And leave me a message in the comments below to tell me what you thought about this episode. Hopefully you learned something new and useful. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course, the project file for this episode, the notes for how to create infinite loop animations, and the presets we created in this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.